Welcome back. We saw already the geometrical interpretation of least squares from perspective of linear algebra. In this video, we will look at an example of this geometrical interpretation on a simple line fitting problem. Let's assume that we have three observations at time equal to 0, 3, and 5 respectively. And we want to fit a line to these three observations, or in other words, we want to estimate the initial position at time 0, that is x0, and the velocity v. We have three observations and two unknowns, and by now, you all know that the observation equation can be written for this problem as this system of linear equations, y equals ax. The system is overdetermined and inconsistent. And the least square solution for this system can be computed, and it gives us 1.6 and 0.26 estimate of x0 and the velocity v. Now let's look at the geometry of this problem. The observation vector is three-dimensional, so I can draw it as the red arrow in the plot on the right. Now let's think about the range space or column space of matrix A. Recall that the range space is the space that is spanned by all the columns of the matrix A. So let's visualize the column of A in this plot. We have two unknown parameters, and so two columns. If I plot them, the green vectors show the first and second columns vectors of A. Now, what is the range space of matrix A? In fact, the range space is a plane that goes through these two green vectors. The plane is visualized as a gray mesh grid in the plot. We can clearly see that the vector y is outside this plane, which indicates the inconsistency of the system. From least squares, we know that the adjusted observation vector y hat is a vector in this plane, and it has the minimum distance to the observation vector y. I have already computed the distance between the observation vector y and all the points on this plane. Let's see the results. In this plot, the colors show the distance between the observation vector and all the vectors lying in the range space of A, in this case, this plane. The color bar shows the range of the color values. So the minimum distance is corresponding to a point in the middle of the blue area. Actually, the vector from 0 to this point should be the y-hat vector, which is the orthogonal projection of the vector y on the range space of A. We can also see the blue dashed vector, which demonstrates the vector of residuals. In order to really see the minimum distance, let's change the color scale. With this new color scale, all the points on the plane with distance larger than 5 from the observation vector are colored as dark red. We can see that indeed y hat corresponds to the point on the range space of A with the closest distance to the vector y. So, in summary, in this section, we learned that the least squares estimation is equivalent to the orthogonal projection of the vector of observation y onto the range space of the design matrix A. I hope this geometrical interpretation has gave you a better insight and understanding of the concept of least squares.